Good evening.
Good evening.
As Ed said, my name is Hillary Marotta, and I have been the lucky one to coordinate the college ring-in for this event, which is special because it's obviously an international college ring-in event, which we don't normally have. We've also been affected by COVID, and so therefore you might see that some of our ringers are a little younger or a little older than college age. But you know, we have to get everybody in, right? So I have had the distinct honor and privilege to watch this group for the past 2 days. They started ringing together on Saturday afternoon. And for those of you like me, who don't remember what day it is or where you are, it is only Monday evening. They have had a very challenging repertoire, and their concert is going to knock your socks off. They have been directed the past 2 days by Mr. Toshikazu Yoshida of Japan, a renowned orchestral and handbell conductor, and Dr. William Payne of Middleburg, Pennsylvania, United States, retired from Bucknell University. And I'm gonna let it up to them, and I bet you're gonna enjoy this.
book, which was written in 1888 by Edward Elgar and his fiancée to celebrate their engagement. He wrote multiple versions for multiple instruments, but this handbell arrangement that you just listened to was arranged by none other than Mr. Ishida himself. This next piece that you'll hear was written by Emily Lee, a handbell musician that was introduced earlier. Ms. Lee, if you could stand and be recognized. Her piece, Nocturnal Fantasy, is inspired by a Chinese poem, Night Thoughts, by Li Bai. The poem is, I wake and moonbeams play around my bed, glittering like hoar frost around my wandering eyes. Up towards the glorious moon I raise my head, then lay me down and thoughts of home arise. Please enjoy this wonderful world of fantasy. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you.
Because this piece is a pioneer in that sense, Nocturne in A minor is a favorite for many Handel groups across the globe.
I
As some of you may know, Glenn Miller was a famous jazz musician. Four of his favorite melodies are featured in this medley: Moonlight Serenade, Little Brown Jug, The American Patrol, and In the Mood. Please enjoy the Glenn Miller classics, and thank you, or as we say in Japan, arigato gozaimasu.
Thank you. sorry.
Okay, so we didn't follow that. Thank you, Mr. Yoshida. What a pleasure. Such an honor and a pleasure to share the podium with Mr. Yoshida. Incredible weekend that we've had. And I was in Japan many years ago, teaching at Kwansai Galpon University and doing some handbell festivals, and we met at that time. And it's just, this is what it's all about. We know human connection, and it's a small world. It was so appropriate. This afternoon, when I left the rehearsal, I walked out into the lobby, and I saw a face of a student that I had at Bucknell many, many years ago, over 30 years ago, and I had not seen him. And he's not a handbell ringer. He was here for another convention. We both looked at each other like, oh my God. So, yeah, it's all about, it is about human connection, and we are one, we truly are. And to come together like this is pretty special. Unlike Mr. Yoshida, the program that you have in front of you is totally wrong on my side. All of the titles are there, but I'm going to do them in a different order. So we're going to start with Time and Tide. And here again, this is about the joy of togetherness in a world that right now is broken, but I think the tides, if they come and go and flow, it's a metaphor for the fact that life goes on and we continue to be together as human beings and want joy in our lives. Time and Tide is written by Rob Riker, who is a former student of mine, and he's been a big help to us this weekend with the College Ringers. And Rob is standing right back here. Raise your hand, Rob. He obviously looks a little older than the rest of the crew. But I'm grateful for his help. And Laura Block is in the back. She also was a very large help to us. So and we both have children in the ensemble. Would you raise your hands, children? So, Time and Tide by Rob Riker.
Thank you.
The next piece I'm going to play is My Strength Comes from Heaven. And this is by Christian Humke, who is also a former student of mine. When I retired from Bucknell, the students organized an alumni reunion, and he wrote this piece for that reunion. And it's now published by Choristers Guild, and I'm really pleased to present this here at this international symposium. Christian works as a musician. He has done a good bit of engraving for me for music that I have published or have written in the past couple of years, and so I'm very grateful to him for that. I think you'll enjoy this piece. It's a very sensitive piece. And then after that opening beautiful section that we play, you'll hear then the ringers come in with mallets. It's very kind of Kevin McChesney-like, but with a little twist. Thank you. This next piece has an interesting history. About a year and a half ago, in the fall, I was contacted by the son of the former student. And he asked me if I would arrange a Van Sant piece sung by Lynyrd Skynyrd for his dad for Christmas, for a Christmas present from the family, from Will and his family. And I said, "Will, this is out of my box." But because it was Butch Schur, my former student, and I had him in high school, when he was in high school, I said to Will, "I'll do it." Because Butch, he was rather obstreperous and sometimes a troublemaker, but he loved bells. And it was so obvious. And so I took the piece. There's no sheet music for it that would work for bells. So I listened on YouTube to Lynyrd Skynyrd singing it. And so I began to write and took it right from the YouTube version and transcribed it for bells. So it's just a real pleasure. This was the first time that I heard it with this college group. And what a joy that they bring to all of us in so many ways. But I am thrilled to offer this. And Will's family is here with Butch. So we had dinner last night, and oh, what fun that was. Lots of stories, lots of memories. So we bring you the Van Sant piece to Tuesday's Dawn.
Thank you.
I said to Butch that he could come to rehearsal, and he said, I don't think so, I want to hear the final product. And I said, well, that means you're only going to cry once. So, next is a piece that I wrote in the middle of the 80s, 1990. I had just gone to Bucknell, and we just went through this horrible pandemic, COVID, still feeling the effects and going through it. But before these guys were born, yeah, we had an epidemic at that time. If you remember, AIDS appeared on the scene. And I lost a good friend, a colleague, to that disease in 1982. And he was a conductor of the Hinsdale Handbell Choir in Hinsdale, Illinois. And he had then gone to the Presbyterian Church in Morristown, New Jersey, where I had been director of music. And that's where he died. And the Hinsdale group asked if I would write a piece in his memory. And I remember going into the chapel, to Rook Chapel at Bucknell University, and sitting down at the piano when I heard that they wanted to dedicate a piece to Dwight in his honor. And the music just came out of me. And rarely do I write a piece in a couple of days. Sometimes it takes months, but this one was there. And I think I told the students because I knew Dwight so well. And one of the students asked, the title is Elegy, but it doesn't sound like a slow, morbid kind of piece. And he said, no, I didn't want it to. I wanted it to celebrate Dwight, but it's full of hope. You will hear anger in places. But the beauty that he brought to so many students is what I wanted to remember in this piece, Elegy.
Thank you.
let me tell you what a pleasure it's been to stand in front of these young people. They're amazing, aren't they? Through the week and just keeping them corralled and together. So, we end with a Carmen fantasy. This is such a fun piece. It was written originally for these instruments called, what is it, Melodious? Melodicas, yes. And I think it was these are internet sensations. Joe Buono, maybe? And who's the other one?
Justin Clark.
Yeah, yes. And they put this together, this arrangement, and then Matt Compton decided to adapt it for bells. And it's so cool. So enjoy, and thank you so much, so much. Thank you. Thank you all. That's all, folks. Thank you all.